corn wet blending's been around for a long time. Corn syrup and corn starch have been part of the food industry in the United States for a long time, many, many years. Through the 70s into the 80s with high-fructose corn syrup, the corn wet milling industry grew pretty dramatically. At that time, the feed products from that really were a byproduct. It was all about making more fructose. And so what you had left over from the corn needed somewhere to go. That started as going as corn gluten feed pellets, primarily over to Europe. And then some of the plants got located further west from into the corn belt where there were more livestock, more cattle, and wet corn gluten feed kind of came to be. Some inherent qualities of it are just great for ruminant diets, but truly was a byproduct. So it was what it was, and it was there when it was there, and it wasn't when it wasn't. You know, the job of that plant was to make corn syrup and fructose, and whatever was left could get sold as feed. So it was extremely variable. Supply was very inconsistent. So that was really the first thing that we thought about was how to fix those two things, how to provide a reliable supply and consistent quality so that cattle feeders could count on it being there and feed it at a consistent level in the diet. You know, the way the cattle feeder dealt with all that variability and unsurety of supply was to buy it when it's cheap, but feed it at a very low level in the diet. So that limited the benefit of it. You didn't get the rumen health benefits when you feed it at 5 or 6% of the diet. You have to feed it up closer to 20 to really see that kick in. So by solving those two things, reliable supply and consistent quality, and doing that for a long time, that really opened the door for a different value proposition. At the core, it was recognizing there was an opportunity to improve performance by replacing starch in the diet.